Oh yeah, we've got the ruddy last battle, haven't we?
Hmm?
In theory, we didn't defeat the boss the last time round.
Hmm. Yeah, sure. Go for it. Why not?
Are you setting it up?
Oh.
Or?
Yeah. Right, hello, Internet.
Hello.
Hello. We are once again returning for our review and speculation. It's not really a review. I don't know why we call it that.
Yeah,
10 out of 10. Would watch again.
Just kind of, ponderings.
Yeah, ponderings. Ponderings! Ponderings is a great name for this show. Once this season of RWBY is over, if we do this again... For like Red versus Blue or the next volume of RWBY, we gotta call it Pondering.
Or we could do it for if you actually watch Assassination Classroom, just say.
Yeah, but that's
good series.
Like,
good series.
That's not running at the moment.
No, fine. Alright.
I mean, I'd do it for Mob or One Punch Man.
Oh, One Punch Man comes out this year, actually.
Yeah, it does. See, that's what we should do next.
One Punch Man.
One Punch Man. Ponderings. it suits that show so well. We digress. So, point allocation. It's... I mean, just in terms of like the list that I put in the video, I have one more correct prediction. But it's kind of bogus because two of mine are there's not going to be an Oscar and there wasn't, and there's not going to be a Tyrion and there wasn't. But you...
There's not going to be things.
You didn't say there was going to be a Tyrion or Oscar, or if you did, I didn't write it down. So...
Well, yeah. There is there.
I think... I mean, if I didn't write it... I normally just listen to them, and then as you say things, I add to the list. So, presumably you didn't say anything to that effect at all. Unless you said there's not going to be an Oscar or a Tyrion, in which case you would be the winner.
I can't, like, I'm trying to remember if I said there would be an Oscar. I didn't think I did. Because we had an Oscar in the last
one. What most likely happened is you didn't say anything about it.
Well, you know, maybe another point to you then.
Yeah, I think, did you catch up last time or did I go ahead again last time?
I think you got ahead.
Oh, that's not good for you.
No.
I only got a few episodes left.
Not trying hard enough. Oh yeah, we're on 10 now, we're near the end. Somehow.
Neither of us got bonus points for the World of Remnant. We were both wrong.
World of Remnant, we were both incorrect. I probably should have predicted what the World of Remnant was. There's another one where you kind of look and go, yeah, if I was thinking about it, I probably could have thought about that.
I stick by my guns with my prediction. I think what this likely means is we're not going to get a Blake episode for a little while. Because if we were going to get a Blake episode next episode or the episode after, I think they would have done a World of Remnant about that. The White Fang. But we already know quite a lot about the White Fang. We don't know so much about the Great War, so...
Yeah, and I guess it is kind of topical. Well, yeah, it's fairly topical. But pretty much always topical, so...
I'm expecting it to be brought up in an upcoming episode, to be honest. I mean, it's been mentioned a couple of times this season. Yeah, so our World of Remnant was the Great War. I guess we'll talk about that afterwards?
Yeah, that did come after episode 10.
Since it came out. That's how we normally do it.
Yeah, we'll do them in order. Seems fair. Could we, Marvelous episode 10, where we actually, one of the first times this season, got to see everyone, I think. Yeah.
Yeah, we did. We saw every single character. Who was first? You've watched it more recently. Remind me.
It was Dear Sweet Yang first, what I remember.
It was Yang. Yeah, right. Yeah. As we predicted, she was training. She's got a metal arm. She's
finding it rather easy-ish to use. So, yeah, fair enough. Not so much the The part of the training of what I've realised so far is not so much the training to actually get her to use a metal arm right. She doesn't seem to have too much of a problem. It's more just the general fighting style she uses.
Yeah, it was more telling her off for pulling her semblance every single time. Yeah. Even though RWBY uses her semblance all the goddamn time. Not necessarily to win fights, but even so.
Presuming that, yeah, the super speed...
I suppose RWBY's semblance isn't, like... inherently destructive.
Mm.
But potentially self-destructive. Yeah.
Helps you get utility. Around. So.
Yeah.
Makes a tornado, and if you're going fast enough, drag a whole team behind you, apparently. Season 2 says so.
Yeah. One of them, like... I guess the major interesting thing about Tai Yang and Yang's conversation was... Well, Tai Yang, at least, certainly believes that Raven is pretty much solely responsible for destroying their team.
Which I kind of want to hear a bit more about. I could probably assume that Raven isn't the cooperative type from what we've seen.
Yeah, it doesn't sound like it. Well, evidently she was able to cooperate in the creation of a child.
Well, there is that, I guess, yeah.
She's kind of out of character for her based on what we've seen. Maybe she was more mellow?
Back in the day, before she returned to her tribe. Damn it. I got green nadoed.
Yeah, I may have shot a couple of them. Sorry about that.
But, well, I'm sure we'll probably hear more about it at a later point, I thought, maybe.
I mean,
it seems to be that we keep hearing little bits about the original team and their goings-ons. Although...
Yeah.
We are, in theory, nearing the end of this season, and if it ends with a certain favourite character dying, I am not going to be best impressed.
Oh, no, I would not be happy if that happened. I don't think it will. I hope it won't. Please don't. We'll talk more about that in a minute.
Please, Jean, discover your secret semblance.
I don't think his secret semblance is healing. I don't know why that's a thing, to be honest. I've seen that in a lot of headcanons and fictions. Yeah.
It was quite amusing, actually. I saw a little video clip that, well, that was a waste of announcement. That pointed out the, one of the other times Crow's unlucky semblance appeared, which is in season 2 in the bar. Didn't realise it, but the bartender kind of, was it, he put the glass down at the bartender
and it slips
out of his hand. You know, like, huh. They can't have been hinting that earlier on, could they?
No, maybe. I feel like they work out a character's semblance when they come up with that character.
But that was a pretty cool.
That's kind of neat. That is kind of neat. Yeah, I know what I was going to say. I would not be surprised if after like this arc, you know, in like 10 years or so, is done. If we don't get like a prequel Red versus Blue style Team Stark.
Team Stark in training.
Yeah, basically. I mean, it seems like they'd find a way to make it plot relevant.
Yeah. Maybe get a flashback going on.
Yeah. Well, like I said, Red versus Blue style.
Yeah, I think it was Weiss after that, wasn't it?
Yes. Weiss having a pretty cool little moment. Like, again, nothing... Well, I guess one thing pretty severe. Firstly, she summons a sword. And Whitley comes in and apparently doesn't think very much of this.
I'm starting to hate Whitley more and more.
He's really gloating, wasn't he?
Oh, yeah.
He's such a prick.
They've definitely managed to make him a really dislikable character. They've achieved that quite well.
They have indeed.
Well, apart from it was Wheatley's little intrusion, and Klein. That's the one I always forget his name. Blisscott,
well, Wheatley. What brings Klein into the scene? Because Whitley leaves and Weiss shuts the door quite comically with the glyphs, and then successfully summons.
Yeah.
Presume from the window exploding outwards, and Klein peeps in and is like, "Are you all right?" And she's like, "Ah, thank you, Klein. There's a fucking knight next to her."
Yeah, don't mind me. I'm just chilling with my mate.
I'm expecting her to break out soonish.
I was going to say, by the looks of it, she might not need help. She's already managed to summon the aid she needs for this, by the looks of it.
Mm.
She's definitely come a long way, considering last season she couldn't really summon at all, basically.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that'd be quite cool to see in a... I don't know what the season finale will be like at this point. But if there is a battle with Wyson, that'd be pretty cool to watch.
Yeah. I doubt that'll be season... Well, I'm sure we'll see all the characters in the season finale. I think a little bit like last year, there'll be a bit of a build-up where lots of things happen in the last few episodes.
Hmm.
I can't see Wyson being, like, final battle material. Although maybe. Be interesting.
Be good to watch. I do want to see a fight with the... now that she can actually summon properly, it'd be great to watch. But,
Yeah.
Well, I'll have to stay tuned and find out, I guess.
So, yeah, that's basically Wyson.
It was basically... They did all have... Because everyone appeared, it was quite short burst for everyone, so...
Yeah.
A lot and not a lot happened at the same time, per se.
Yeah.
Apart from the last two. Speaking of last two, though, we'll move on to RWBY.
Oh, she was very, very, very last, wasn't she?
Was RWBY Blake's the very, next. Very last?
Yeah.
Episode
ended with RWBY.
Yes.
Blake.
Blake.
And son, chasing down... I was wrong, not the leader of the White Fang.
Nah. A old friend
another character! Whose name escapes me again.
I feel like it was like an Eleanor or something like that, maybe.
Yeah, it was something like that.
But
I
no,
will
no.
look it up and insert a piece of text saying the crate. Because this is getting ridiculous. We don't know the names of anything.
People would debate whether we're actually RWBY fans.
Probably.
I mean, we are. I'm just terrible with names, but...
Well, the names are starting to get, like, RWBY, easy to remember. Who knows? Who could forget that? You know.
They are adding quite a lot more characters in now, so keeping on track at all. Oh.
Can't we remember when they all had nice names, like Shopkeep?
Shopkeep.
We haven't seen Shopkeep this volume.
Oh, yeah.
It will be a real shame if we don't see Shopkeep this volume.
Please say he's the one with the medicine.
Maybe. No, I don't think we'll see him outside Vale. Alright. Quick theory. Yang is going to go to Vale at the very end of this volume, and in the last episode we will see Shopkeep.
End of season prediction right there.
Mm-hmm. It's going to end with he's going to be the end credit scene. Oh, end credit scene.
Last scene is just him.
I really wonder what the end credit scene would be this volume.
Hmm.
I guess we'll come to predict that. When the time comes.
When and where.
Anyway, massive distraction. They get into a fight with a thingy with an extendy sword.
Spike. I swear it's like a whip, but it's also kind of...
It's like a whip that's a sword.
Yeah.
And she's a chameleon. Mm. It's interesting. We've not seen a chameleon Faunus before. Nor have we seen a scorpion Faunus, of course. But
they appeared nonetheless.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Learning a few more things about the Faunus each and every time.
Yeah.
Well, that was pretty different. She seems to change different colours depending on emotion as well, so...
Yeah.
Old friend of Blake's as well, by the sounds of it, or...
Blake...
Rival.
Sounded... It almost sounded like someone familiar to Blake.
Mm.
It's kind of hard to tell. But certainly, Chameleon Girl... I'm just going to call her Chameleon Girl. Oscar is still... Well, I guess Oscar's Oscar now. He was Farmer Kid in my head for a long time. definitely seemed kind of like not really wanting to fight Blake, but you know, it's for the cause, what have you.
Mm.
Type I guess, thing.
That, yeah, she was. Well, Blake was a heavy part of the White Fang at one point, so they probably were friends a while back.
Whatever feeling she may have for Blake, though, she clearly did not share with Sun, because poor Sun gets.
Yep.
Firstly, Sun uses his semblance in a very creative way in this fight.
Yeah,
just creating a whole bunch of them and flopping them on top of me.
You would have thought just fighting and using four people to take out one person would be a more practical approach, but apparently just
really?
Holding them down would have been...
Honestly, like, Sun was cool when they introduced him, and he's just slowly worked his way into the uncool category. I feel kind of sorry for him. He's been... Well, poor Sam. Anyway, yeah, so they go for the scroll, because Chameleon Girl, like an idiot, drops her scroll. I mean, who does that? And they're like, oh, look, there must be secret White Fang plans on the scroll.
I think they
go to grab it.
Don't they... I'm trying to think. Does Blake... They do actually get it in the end, even if Thingy does get stabbed.
Blake gets the scroll. Thingamabob runs away... because of reasons, not wanting to fight Blake, maybe, I don't know. But she does give Sun a good stabbing, which is what I was getting to.
A damn good skewering.
He gets injured. Another injured character. Oh boy. Maybe he'll die.
You were there, like, I'm pretty sure your prediction was that they may break up, or that'd be a good way for the story to go. But I can see this being their reunion straight from the off, from how Blake reacted to this. She became quite lovey-dovey quite quickly.
Oh, I see. So a fellow has to get seriously stabbed before the girl notices him?
Sort of worked, I guess.
Weep. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think they're very...
very compatible.
It's not even like the hordes and hordes of bumblebee shippers who just want Blake to break up with Sun because of reasons. It's practically impossible to get knocked down in this fight, Tarrin.
I wouldn't say that. I just managed it. Bumblebee shippers as well.
Yeah. I kind of forgotten that was a thing until just now.
That would be hilarious if it happened.
I don't know about hilarious. It'd be a little bit... I feel like if they did it, everyone would just think that they were being cheap, because there is a very large amount of people who want that. I mean, I'm sure they will get together, I just don't think they should.
Don't think it's a wise move, but...
I mean... I don't know. I don't see it. I'm not convinced.
I'm kind of hoping they might add a bit more in just to... I don't know, maybe put a bit more development between those two to kind of, if they are going to make them get together.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise it's just like, I guess they're together, but it's only still sort of from feelings from the first one. I mean, okay, he's kind of stalked her a bit across the nation to follow her back to her home, but you know, apart from that.
Yeah, so... That pretty much sums up Blake and Sun, I think. They have a scroll full of White Fang's secrets.
In theory.
Or nothing. Sun is badly injured and will have to be treated. So Blake will have to play nurse, I guess. And not in a kinky way.
It wouldn't be the first time I've seen it, especially in anime industry. It's like, I see. No, as you've been injured, well, now you're completely special again.
Anywho... The last part of the episode was Rubes.
The many struggles of Team RWBY.
Boy, that Ranger. Part of the story went from like one of the chirpiest, happiest, to just bleak and...
It did get bleak rather quickly, I feel. Considering that originally they were just like... You got the whole kind of happy campers kind of atmosphere from them. Now this is just complete... There's probably more despair than any of the other groups, really.
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty bleak. They're carrying Crow along to take him to Mistral. It sounds like they're expecting to get there soonish.
Well, the sign was implying that they've not got far. I feel like it's going to be last-minute struggles. But, I can't really say until we explained what happened, but...
nothing much happened. They decide to split up. They come to a mountain that they cannot pass. One way they think leads...
It's one way is to a town, and the other way is the mountain pass, isn't it? Or to an abandoned, wrecked town. Which
Nora
I get the
and
feeling...
Ren, they don't think they can take Crow through the mountain pass. So Nora and Ren go over the mountain pass to potentially go to Mistral and bring help back. And then Jean and RWBY take the easier route to the abandoned town. But easier may be subjective based on what we see at the very, very end.
Yep.
That footprint again.
Footprint.
Presumably of that one Grimm that...
Destroyer Grimm of worlds. Talking about. Nations.
Yeah. Destroyer of cities, at least. When was the last time he stuck his bloody tail in the ground?
A while. I almost got the feeling that Ren and Nora really did not want to go to that town.
Yeah.
But which makes me feel like maybe that's the town that Ren's from, possibly us. Though I swear we...
Well,
he's separated
no, because
from.
Ren's family were from the last town that they went to.
Hmm.
Name unknown, still.
But, yeah, so pretty much that. So they can't... They feel that trying to take Crow up the mountainside would take too long. So they're going to go... Well, they split up.
Yeah, basically.
And I get the feeling that Ruddy, RWBY and Jean will get into trouble. But at the last second, Nora and Ren will turn up with some help. Maybe yeah. Tai Yang. Who knows? He's heading over there, I think.
No, he's still in Vale.
Yeah,
he's still training Yang.
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure he said he was going
to
head over there.
How would Tai Yang get all the way to Haven?
He's got connections.
I don't see it, Tarrin. So, yeah. Yeah, that's basically... That, I think, is setting up the finale of
Final
them
couple.
Having a fight. Having a fight with Grimm and losing until Ren and Nora come along.
I feel like they're going to be having someone in tow. I don't know who.
Well, yeah, probably someone from the kingdom.
I can't think of anyone we actually know who's already over there, though.
No one.
Well, that means another new character, though.
Probably.
Unless Raven intervenes, but...
I doubt it'll be a major character. It'll probably just be a... Raven could still step in to save her brother. I don't know if she would.
She used to be quite mellow, apparently, considering she settled down and once had a family, but not anymore, by the way.
I don't know about settled down.
Well, oh yeah, I would say settled down, but actually she left as soon as she had Yang, didn't she? So
pretty much. If the timelines are to make sense, she would have had to have left almost straight away. Otherwise, RWBY was born. Was born rather soon after Yang. To have only a 2-year difference—that's quite a jump from presumably married to. In a new relationship.
I was going to say, you've got to give it to Tai Yang. He's a quick mover.
Yeah.
Yeah? Struggle is on for the next couple of episodes, by the looks of it.
Remnant. That's basically it for this episode. World of Remnant. The Great War. What did we really learn from the Great War?
You see, I thought the Great War, for some reason, was started predominantly because of the... The Faunus. Turns out it wasn't.
No, the Faunus rights movement was after.
Yeah.
Which is weird, because it seems like slavery was more rampant before, but, you know.
Considering in theory, yeah, slavery was abolished at the Great War, but, well, I guess you can't stop it.
Well, it wasn't slavery that they were worried about, was it? It was just an equal right.
No, it started, and also partly why the colours are there, but I think we all sort of knew that one before.
Yeah.
It started because of... name of countries, names again, killing me.
Atlas decreed that they should not have any more art.
Or any sort of self-expression.
Now, Austin made it sound worse, like that across the world, all... forms of art and self-expression were destroyed, but from the sounds of things, it was just Atlas and bits of Mistral.
They probably brought... When they invaded, they probably tried to affect it, and I mean, Vacuo seemed completely out of it by the looks of it. They didn't have anything to do with it until the war started, so they seemed clear on the matter as well.
I think they missed a trick. If they established Mistral's like the Arty Kingdom, I would have made Vale one of... I would have made Vale Atlas's ally, I think. Because I feel like they've just made Vale the good country, because that's the one that we
see the most of, generally.
Yeah, the one that RWBY and the main characters are from.
It was quite cool that the the renegade nation, per se, Australia of the RWBY world, joined with the proverbial good team to try and beat off the enemy. I did quite enjoy that. It was it was quite a nice little bit of information. I enjoyed the little tale a bit.
Yeah. It wasn't like, obviously there was war, so there were lots of Grimm, and they would take turns fighting each other, then the Grimm would come, they'd all fight the Grimm, and then they'd go back to fighting each other. It does sound pretty awful.
Peace, but...
It's probably a slight commentary on our world.
There is that. Wow.
Then at the end, the King of Vale himself went into the fray, into the decisive final battle, in which he apparently just immolated hundreds of people.
I kind of want to see this guy in action, because he did sound a bit like a legend.
Yeah.
They were struggling, it could have gone bad, and he himself thrashed the entire lot of them. And all the nation was bowed to the king.
We can see how powerful, like, really powerful people are, you know, already.
You get tasted.
Like, can you imagine, like, those normal soldiers that Ironwood had going up against, like, Tyrion, or even Cinder now she's a maiden, like, just being slaughtered by the hundreds.
It would be a bit Spartan-esque, wouldn't it? But, I'll say now, I'm not sure if you agree, but that definitely looked like it was Ospin's cane.
I see, I didn't rewatch it to check. I'm sure it does. And I wouldn't be surprised if the leaders of the kingdoms were in possession of the relics, because this is before the academies.
Oh, yeah.
Which would help explain why he was so powerful, in addition to just being a really powerful guy, I'm sure. And if he set up the academies, you know, the king's scepter became the cane that Ospin uses. I'm personally still of the theory that Ospin was alive during the events of the Great War, because they make a point of saying, or Monty made a point of saying, that his name doesn't follow the Colour Rule.
Yeah, but as you said, neither did Oscar's.
Yeah, but then neither does Ironwood's, really, because James. We don't know what Oscar's surname is.
There are some that don't follow, and it isn't like a mandatory rule, it's just a...
Well, it seems like it's more of just a cultural development. For the same reason that no one really names their children like Chihuahua.
I don't think that's cultural development, that's just not being stupid.
Yeah, but you see what I mean? Like, why are the words that we have as names, why are certain words acceptable as names and others not? It's just because of how it's developed over time. Anyway, like, yeah, I think for intents and purposes for the characters in the show, it is a rule. I think they do make a point of giving most characters either a first name or a surname or both, which is a colour.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we have to escape, don't we? Whoops.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, don't feel like playing through all over again.
Oh, no. We've only got, like, two more of these anyway. Right? 10, 11, and 12. Potentially another one on top of that if there's 14 episodes.
Well, yeah.
So no, I don't.
I think I did briefly play Nora, but... Meh, I'll go for Nora anyway. Actually.
Marvellous.
I know RB. Let's be Bumblebee.
Okay.
Future relationship.
That's what a lot of people want. From even before the first episode came out.
And it's already assumed that Ruddy Yang is straight, considering on the first... Was it when they were at the beacon?
Or by...
What?
Or by...
Fair shout.
Tarrin, you're not being very inclusive.
There has been no suggesting evidence for Yang to be bi.
Neither of them.
So far. Nor Blake, for that matter. They both appear to be straight.
People still all about that, though.
We'll see. I still think that it's going to be Blake and Son chilling together to the bitter end.
Anyway, where were we? Predictions, I guess.
Yeah. I'm trying to remember what I'm predicting now. What have we got? 11,
next 12? Two episodes. Yeah. 11 and 12. But just do characters, you know.
I'll just run characters. Through everyone. What's the word?
Yeah. Characters, then villains, and Oscar. That is the usual. Anywho. Predictions. You go first. Predict?
I think I've actually already pretty much predicted RWBY, haven't I?
Reiterate. Makes it easier for me.
I also kind of want to be slightly different, because I feel like our prediction on RWBY is probably going to be very much the same.
Well, I'm going to try and be, like... Not try and be inaccurate, but I'm not going to try very hard, because I think I am pulling into the lead, and that's...
I think that's a point there, though, Dan. You're supposed to be winning away. Competitive spirit law.
It's not really a competitive show, is it?
Fine. But if next time we see Team Ranger, I feel like we'll get... I'll say a slice of action from Nora and Rem trying to climb a mountain and them running into trouble. I don't think we'll see... RWBY and Jean carrying Crow yet. But I would have thought that's quite bitter end stuff.
Yeah.
So, those two going over the mountain and getting to Minstrel, hopefully. Minstrel?
Minstrel.
Weiss? She seems like she's ready to try and get out, make a break. That seems like what she was basically about to ask Klein to help her with.
Yeah, she asked for a favour. We didn't mention that, actually. She asked Klein for a favour.
Mm. So, presumably, that favour is to... I want to say get to...
I'm going to start the game.
...Atlas and meet up with Ironwood and find a way out that way.
Oh, interesting.
Blake? Well, she's got to now recover her beloved fallen lover... son, and find out what's on the scroll.
Yep.
Maybe get intercepted by Fox 1 and Fox 2, the two suspicious chaps again. We haven't seen those in a while.
Oh, yeah.
So I think they're going to be intercepting them at the house, personally. Yeah.
Okay. Do you mean that Fox and Wolffellow are going to show up at the house? At their house?
They're not going to show
up. Or Blake's going to go and find them?
Blake's going to be trying to carry Sun back, or...
Jump in, Tarrin, this time.
Yeah, going to be trying to get Sun back. The Wolfie and Foxy intervene and try and stop her. And she sacrifices the scroll, but gets Sun back. There you go.
Okay.
Solid prediction.
Yang,
I don't know, finishes training? Poor Yang, hasn't had a lot of action this season, poor Yang.
Oh no, I think they're going to leave off with something more than just finishes training. Come on, Tarrin, we're getting to the penultimate episode, potentially.
Potentially. There's just so much that needs to happen yet. Although they are quite chunky episodes, so the amount they could fit in...
Yeah, they are.
Nope, I can't really predict much further than that, yeah. Tai Yang's going to see that Yang is prepared and ready, and Yang's going to join in with Tai Yang wherever he's going. There you go.
Okay.
That's as good as my foresight skills go. There's probably a reason I'm slowly dropping behind the lead at the moment.
Yeah, probably. Well, okay. Oscar?
He'll appear in the next episode.
In the very next episode?
In the very next episode.
You don't have to specify an episode, you can just say he'll show up.
Oh, show up, too easy. He's appearing next.
In the next episode, we'll get Oscar.
Yeah.
Villains.
Villains.
Okay, we're surely going to see the villains. At least once.
We haven't had a good little table meeting, and in theory, Tyrion's heading back there to weep his sorry tears into Salem. I eventually remember her name.
So okay, as long as that's the only thing he's putting into her.
What? So I feel like we're going to have a little... I completely missed whatever you said.
It's okay, it wasn't important.
But we're going to have a little... Yeah, him being sorry around the crown table. I doubt we're going to see the other... I would have thought the other guys will appear on the last episode. As in, arriving wherever they'll be going.
Okay.
In theory, Watson... there's a potential that they can pin Belinda Watson, considering he's over in that city at the moment anyway. But,
Do I save it to be a prediction, or wouldn't that be an amazing twist if Nora and Ren get back and they have Dr. Watts with them? That would be so great. He gets to be cool and be a badass, like we know he will because of his badass mustache, right? And the potential drama.
Oh, wait, I know you. You're the silver-eyed one we're supposed to be killing.
No, I think he'll be more coy about it than that, Tarrin.
Well, he's Dr. Watts, you know.
He will be cool under pressure, and he'll say nothing. And he will bide his time until he wins and takes over the world. He deserves it. That man deserves it.
Overthrows Salem. Oh, dear. It would be brilliant if that actually happened.
That would be brilliant.
Pardon me.
I don't know if that would, but that is... It solves all of the problems we know. He's in Mistral. He's not a new character per se. Like, I'm just saying. I'm just saying.
It's there. The possibility's there.
I'm sorry to interrupt. What were you saying? Dr. Watts is going to show up at some point.
I was going to say possibly that Nora and Ren get intercepted by Dr. Watts. But I guess they don't actually know about Nora and Ren. They don't really care about those two. They're only after RWBY. So in theory...
That's not his job either. Like, he's probably doing some, like, politics nonsense or something. Like, getting in bed with the headmaster or something. Not literally, of course.
Something of that. Unless, of course, something suiting of Dr. Watts. His stature.
Well, suiting of Dr. Watts is absolutely anything, because that man is a masterpiece, but... you know what I mean?
Yeah, I feel like we're going to have a little round table meeting again sometime soon, but I think that's about it as far as enemies, because the big boss is setting up to be whatever the huge ass Grimm is.
Yeah.
So Tyrion's somewhat been dealt with and already run off, so it seems to be him sorted. It kind of made it look like we should see Adam sometime soon, but I feel like that might be a last episode thing, maybe.
I don't know about that.
We'll just get a snippet of where he actually is, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, potentially. Anything else?
That's it, isn't it? Prayer mulch.
Okay. So that's all your predictions.
Yeah.
RWBY, I disagree with you. I think that's,
Dang it.
I would say we're not going to see Nora and Ren at all until they come and save the day. I think if we see RWBY and Jon, and I'm sure we will, especially if it is potentially the penultimate two episodes, then I don't think we'll see Nora and Ren. Yeah, I think whatever nasty thing they're going to encounter, again, assuming this is the penultimate two episodes, I think will show up. So we'll see a big Grimm. They'll get into trouble, and then the last episode will be the actual, you know, fight.
Dr. Watts comes, save the day.
Yeah, I'm not going to predict that, because obviously I'm assuming that's going to be episode 12 stuff, but I like that idea.
It's a pretty good idea.
That idea. A lot. They'll get into trouble. Like, either, like, trouble's about to come and they're like, oh, shit, and it's a cliffhanger. Or trouble shows up, they try and fight it, and then it's a cliffhanger. They've liked cliffhangers this volume, so I think it's a fairish assumption.
Okay.
Weiss? I think she will break out in the next two episodes. and we'll go to Atlas Academy. There's not much to it. I part of me thinks there's going to be a moment where she actually like faces off against her dad.
Ooh.
I'm seeing, and he gets absolutely curb stomped because he doesn't believe in being a huntsman. And thus isn't one. Presumably.
I was going to say,
I don't know. I just like the idea of him being really weak.
Or, what's a brother called?
Whitley.
That's the one.
I don't think we'll see Whitley get stomped. I think he'll get his comeuppance later. I don't think we'll see him get
something
stomped.
Deserving of him.
Anyhow, so that's basic. That's basic nonsense. She's going to wreck shop, probably destroy a lot of things in the process. I hope so.
Like, just destroy that house. Leave. Flip a table.
Blake and Son. Blake and Son, I think, are good. Blake is going to take him back to her house to be healed. I think you're right that the two fellows will show up, but I don't think they'll show up like aggressively. I think they'll show up to talk to the leader again.
Maybe they'll get summoned because of any incriminating evidence on the scroll, perhaps. I don't know.
I kind of see that as where their story's leaving off. It's like they have this scroll and stuff they need to investigate, and that's kind of how next volume starts, maybe. And... Yang, and I think this probably will happen in the next two episodes. Like, I don't know if she's going to be like, "You're ready," but Tai Yang's going to be like, I think you can take care of yourself. I'm going to leave to find your sister.
Mm.
And I think Yang will want to come along, but I think he'll, for whatever reason, she'll have to, I'll defend Station 1, she'll have to stay in Vale and fight the good fight in Vale with Glinda. Again, I'm almost still thinking that Glinda's going to rock up there.
Just chill at
the... Because I can't want to see Glinda.
Yeah. Glinda's day off at the house. I can't remember when I predicted that for. That was a couple of episodes back, but you're still there.
Well, I don't think she's going to show up to, like, have a chat. I think she's going to show up specifically to say, like, I'm here to take this really good huntress away so that she can fight Grimm. Sorry, Tai Yang.
Kind of
need
her.
She's going to be all business. Glinda strikes me as an all-business woman. No nonsense.
Oh, she is a nonsense. Yeah. Except for the odd bit of banter with Ironwood every now and then. Anyway,
yeah, I feel that's more like we're once lovers, now are not banter.
Mm.
Let's see. So I think that's how it's going to shape up. Tai Yang's going to leave to find RWBY. And Yang's going to either stay at the house and train by herself, or more likely go to Vale. Like, Tai Yang's going to be like, you should get back into the fight. Bye. And yeah. Or, I don't know if Tai Yang's like, I'm getting back into the fight. Bye. And Yang's like, but wait, you haven't finished training me. And he's like, yes, I have.
Yes, I have, fool. Go do it with yourself.
Anyway, Yang's going to be finished with training and they're going to split up.
Right.
As opposed to stay together.
Yeah.
Oscar, I mean, it's pretty obvious we're going to see him.
Which episode, Dan? Which episode?
I'm going to say 11, because you're saying 10.
I thought we just had
10. 10 and 11. No, we just had 9.
Did we? Yeah. My bad.
Yeah, 12 would be the finale.
The finale.
Which, if it is a finale, means we'll be tackling it all on its own.
Wah!
Because we tackled 1 all on its own all the way back when. Well, and 4 World of Remnants. Remnants.
Remnants.
World of Remnants.
Time for another World of Remnants.
Yeah.
No, yeah.
So...
Bad guys
will show up, and like you said, Tyrion's going to be moaning to Salem. I mean, that's pretty... I don't think it's going to happen in these next two episodes, but I think I'm going to stick with my idea that Watson's Dr. Watts is going to be the guy to show up with Ren and Nora. Like, the brilliance of that.
If that happens, fair shout.
Would
I mean,
be
sounds
great.
Awesome.
Like, otherwise, I thought he would be the end credit scene, because he's likely going to end up being, like, the next villain. You know, being in Mistral and all. The next sort of villain that they encounter. But, yeah, no, I that would be a really good way to introduce him and, like, blow everybody's minds, except for mine, because I'm...
You've already predicted it.
Unless I'm wrong.
And all... are we at three? I can't even remember how many viewers we have now.
We actually went up a little bit. We're about at 10.
Oh, yeah.
10, 11.
You 10 out there.
I mean, that's
there,
not bad for one of our
10.
Videos.
You'll also know.
I mean, a couple of which are probably us.
Yeah. Two of which are probably us, at least.
Yeah, probably. I try not to watch our videos too much.
Just so I get a more realistic view of if there's actually anyone
well, yeah.
else
see,
out
because it wouldn't affect someone getting 100-odd views, but for us it makes quite a significant percentage difference.
Disappointing.
I mean, I
fact,
could
really,
double our
but...
view count. I could double our view count in about an hour. Less. So, yeah, Tyrion's going to be complaining. And I still don't know if Salem's going to take it well or badly.
We did discuss this in the last one, I think, because we made a prediction for him.
I got a really nice, I got a really big, like, nice boss vibe from her in the first episode, and then the second time I got more of a maybe slightly mean vibe. I don't know, I just think it'd be kind of nice if she was, like, not nice, but, like, an evil villain who understands that you have to look after your minions if you want to keep their loyalty.
Yeah. Basically, good villain.
I'm sure she's not above getting angry at them, if with subsequent failures. But if Tyrion comes back with no tail, that's a pretty big like, hey. I mean, because remember how she treated Cinder when Cinder came back mute and unable to use her powers, apparently,
and so, missing an eye.
And missing an eye. Yeah, forgot about the eye.
We'll see what comes up. See what comes up in the next couple of episodes. What? I say that quite a lot, just because, you know, predicting powers only go so far, people.
Yeah.
Especially mine, so... rather limited inspiration. Look, I've had a stubbed toe today. I'm living life on the edge. It's difficult, you know?
Stubbed toe is a complimentary way of putting that.
Yeah. I dropped a 5-kilogram weight on it from my height, which... if you people out there know, is quite high up.
Yeah. So yeah, those are our predictions.
Yeah.
I'll count them up.
We'll see if our predictions are right in the weeks to come. I'm sure we'll be surprised yet again, as we seem to continue be.
Usually are.
Normally at blindingly obvious ones as well.
So yeah. Thanks for watching to us ramble. Ponder.
Yeah. Again. Ponder on the topic of RWBY.
Yeah.
Please... please tune in again.
bye.
Toodles.
Toodle pip.